Hi everyone, my name is Nikita and I will show you how to stitch a dataset from 2x2 tiles using BigStitcher. mesoSPIM can save images in BigDataViewer H5 format, which I will use here. So let's begin. Open the BigStitcher plugin from Fiji menu. An input window will pop up, which allows you to import your data. Our raw data is contained in the H5 file, and information about tiles, channels and illumination directions in the XML file. To import the data, drag and drop the XML file into the input form. The dataset size is about 80 GB, but the import happens instantly because BigDataViewer loads only the requested plane instead of the whole dataset. For historical reasons, mesoSPIM data was originally saved in a raw file format, with separate file for every channel, illumination and tile. For completeness of this video, I will quickly show how to import this format as well, but this is very tedious way and definitely not recommended. So you can skip the next 2 minutes if you don't use RAW or TIFF files for your data. Clicking on one or more tiles selects them for BigDataViewer display. Navigation uses some non-standard shortcuts, like up and down arrows for zoom, and it takes some practice to get used to it. By default, the tiles are grouped by channels and illuminations for compact display. Uncheck the grouping options to see individual channel and illumination for a selected tile. Press F1 for BigStitcher shortcuts lookup. For example, use C key for random coloring of your tiles. Use BigDataViewer pull menu to adjust your lookup tables. In this dataset, for every tile and channel, there is left and right illumination. One of them always has better quality, and you can select the best illumination using the context menu. In the menu that pops up, choose the relative Fourier ring relation, because illumination brightness can be biased due to laser power differences between left and right arms. After about 5 minutes, a dialog pops up that allows you to preview and confirm or change the illumination to keep. Use it to make sure that your selected illumination has the best quality. In this example, the last 2 selections are incorrect and I changed them manually. After you click apply, unfortunately the lookup tables and viewport positions are reset, so you need to adjust them manually. If you are afraid that you made a mistake on previous step, don't worry. Your bad illuminations are not deleted from the dataset, they are only marked as missing in the XML file, and you can always undo this. Now let's do the actual stitching on selected channel. Go back to Stitched menu, right-click and select Stitch Dataset. In the dialog, select Downsampling Factors. Stitching using downsampled images is faster and actually gives better quality than using full resolution. In about 15 minutes, and this time is mostly spent on downsampling, your stitching is ready for preview. Usually no modifications are required here, but you can check the links of each tile. If all looks good, click Apply and Run Global Optimization and then select the default option. Congratulations, now the data is stitched and your log messages should look like this. You can zoom in and play with the tile colors, shortcut C, to make sure that the stitching is accurate. Now you need to fuse the four tiles into a single 3D image. Click Image Fusion, select Data Type and Downsampling. By default, Fusion makes voxels isotropic. Click Preserve Original Anisotropy if you want the same Z-step between planes as in the original data. Select the output file format. Fusion and saving takes about 20 minutes. When done, load the fused TIFF file into Fiji and check the stitching quality. In this example, stitching in vertical direction has no visible marks. Between left and right tiles, there are some fusion marks at the background, but not at bright intensities. This happens because fusion intensity adjustment is biased toward brighter regions, which is usually your signal. Your data typically has more than one channel, and you can stitch several channels using the same menu. Select the channels you want to stitch in the grouped view and follow the same procedure as before. A dialog will pop up that allows you to select which channel to use for stitching. The stitching transform will be applied to all channels you selected. Downsampling involved in stitching takes quite some time, but you can speed up computations if you resave the raw data in H5 downsampled at multiple levels or pyramids. This is all for today. Please post your comments below if you have questions. Thanks for watching.